Hello everybody, this is the first episode of Screencasts about React PHP. To better understand the asynchronous world and the way it works, we will start with the basics. Event loop is the heart of any asynchronous application. Furthermore, all this asynchronous magic will be impossible without the loop. The main purpose of it is to allow us to register events and appropriate handlers for these events. When an event is being triggered, an appropriate handler is being called. This event-driven architecture allows us to break the traditional synchronous flow. I know that at first it may sound a bit confusing, so let's start with some examples. I assume that you're familiar with JavaScript and its asynchronous nature. In JavaScript, we have event loop available out of the box. We don't see it because it is running behind the scenes. For example, let's write a very simple asynchronous code with JavaScript. We can use setTimeout function to delay the execution for a specified callback. Our callback delays the string output for a second. Then, to prove that it actually has been delayed, we print one more message. When we run the code, you can see asynchronous in action. Even if the statement that prints before timeout string goes after set timeout call, it has been executed first, and then, in 1 second, the delayed callback has been called. Now, let's try to implement the same things with React PHP. First of all, in PHP, we don't have event loop running in background. That means that each time we write asynchronous code in PHP, we need to explicitly define the loop. React PHP has a package that implements event loop. So, let's install it via Composer. We create a loop via the factory. Then, to delay some code, we can use a timer. Method addTimer accepts a number of seconds and a callback. This callback will be executed once the timer is off. Again, we use the same message printing as we did with JavaScript. And one more note. Because we have to explicitly create an instance of the event loop, we also need to explicitly run it by calling loop run. So, let's run our PHP code. You see the same result as we previously had in JavaScript. The synchronous flow has been changed. If we compare this code with its JavaScript version, you can notice that actually it looks the same. The only difference is that we have to explicitly define and run the loop. The event loop will be executed until it has something to do. Once all registered handlers has been called, the loop stops and the flow control moves back to the synchronous code. For example, if we forget to call loop run, no asynchronous code will be executed. Now we go on with JavaScript. Another well-known function is setInterval, which allows to repeatedly execute a callback in a certain amount of time. When we run this code, it starts printing the same message every second. Let's move back to PHP Storm and try to implement the same behavior with React PHP. We start with a new file. Require Composer Autoload. Create a loop. To repeatedly execute some code, we again can use timers. Method addPeriodicTimer accepts an interval in seconds and a callback. This callback will be repeatedly called in a specified interval. But now we have a problem. As you can see, we are dealing with an infinite loop. To stop it, we need to manually interrupt the script. But what if we want to repeatedly show only 5 messages? And on the 6th iteration, we need somehow cancel the timer. For this purpose, we can add a simple counter. Then pass it by reference into the callback. Inside the callback, we increment it and then check. If it is the 5th iteration, we should cancel the timer. Event loop may have a lot of timers. How can we detect the one that we need? Actually, there are two ways. Both methods addTimer and addPeriodicTimer return an instance of the created timer. We can assign this instance to a variable and then use this variable inside the callback. To cancel the timer, we also need an instance of the loop. We call method cancelTimer on it. Try things out. And now we have only 5 printed messages, and then the script stops. Another approach is more elegant and can be used when you need to access to the timer inside this callback. It turns out that behind the scenes every callback accepts an argument, which is an instance of this callback's timer. We can use this argument to cancel the timer. Run the code and the same result, but now without additional variables. Now I'll open the code we have written before. You can notice a pattern here. Every asynchronous application in React PHP consists of 3 steps. We create event loop, configure the behavior, and then run the loop. By its nature, event loop runs in a single thread, and all the handlers are being executed asynchronously, but not in parallel. That means that our timers are not time accurate and can't be delayed. Actually, when we specify the number of seconds for a timer, that means that this timer will be executed not earlier than the specified time. The code runs in one thread and can't be interrupted. So, when we have some blocking stuff inside one of the handlers, the whole loop will be blocked and all other handlers will be delayed. To demonstrate this, we can use a blocking sleep function, which blocks the thread for a specified amount of seconds. Again, we create the loop, add a timer that will repeatedly print message every second. Then we add one more timer that executes sleep function. Run the code and you can see that the first callback is being executed once and then the whole loop is being blocked for 5 seconds. Even if we have specified a timer to execute a callback every second, actually the second call has been delayed for 5 seconds. Remember, you should never block the loop. This is all for this video. It was a quick introduction to event loop, the core of any asynchronous application. We have covered timers and how they can be used to defer and delay some code, and thus break the synchronous flow of PHP script. Thanks for watching.